It's a warning of dire need tonight. 14 nonprofit shelters in the state of Utah may not be able to provide for domestic violence victims come next year. This comes in the wake of record clients seeking aid to get out of a bad situation. As ABC4 investigator Jason Wynn explains, the only thing that can save our shelters is an act of Congress or help from the state legislature.
Survivors started coming out because the abuse that they were experiencing was escalating.
Jill Anderson is the executive director of CASPA in Cache Valley. She is preparing for a 25% cut in the shelter's budget because of a lack of congressional funding in the Victims of Crime Act.
For our organization alone, that's around a $250,000 cut.
During the pandemic, CASPA saw more than 2,500 calls a quarter for help. She says those seeking shelters alone are up 60%.
Will services like that go away if you lose this kind of funding?
Absolutely, our ability to provide housing support for survivors would be jeopardized.
Meaning domestic violence shelters would have fewer safe places for victims to go, reduced staffing, and more importantly, training.
We don't get better when we can't train our staff.
Margaret Rose is the executive director at YCC Family Crisis Center in Ogden. She says her shelter could lose roughly $215,000 with the cuts.
It's a pretty dark scenario, frankly.
Domestic violence shelters hope if Congress won't act, Utah's state legislature will help during the 2021 session.
We'd be facing significant cuts if we can't get that replaced in the next few months.
Potentially slowing down the many years of Utahns' work to help save the lives of those in an abusive relationship. In Salt Lake City, I'm Jason Wynn, ABC4 News.